Hello and welcome to Channel 48. My name is Puk. In the previous video you saw that the Samsung Galaxy S6 got an official upgrade to Android 8.1. Officially by Resurrection. Not by Samsung, but by Resurrection. And there was one phone in my collection, in fact two phones. Two phones are still waiting for Oreo to come, and that is the Samsung S3 9300. But in some way it takes really long, because even the Samsung S2 got Oreo by Rinando, a pretty good version. But now, yesterday, I also saw that our friends of Resurrection, let me tell you who Resurrection in fact is, how you can see Resurrection. In Linux world you have Ubuntu and Linux Mint. And in fact Linux Mint is in fact Ubuntu, but even more tweaked. That's the way how you should see Resurrection. LinuxOS and Resurrection, this is family. This is like, you know, one blood. So that's why these ROMs always have kind of the same things on board, such as privacy guard, etc. You know, you don't find them in these other ROMs. So Resurrection also released Oreo officially for the Samsung S4, the GFL Tex, and that is really fantastic. This is only for the 9505, okay? That is the international model. So in no way this is for the 9500, because the 9500 has different hardware. So sorry you guys, this is really only and for the international model. So how is it? I tested it for I think, let me see, last battery charge was 22 hours ago, and I just grabbed the phone and saw that it was at 2%, so it was standby for at least 20 hours, but I also did not do too many things with it. So probably we will have to tweak it a little bit and make it, you know, even better. I did not set up the firewall, did not set up my privacy guard. All these things you can tweak, and they save battery life, really they do. You know, it makes a difference if an application does boot up. It makes a difference if an application has access to all these places that it wants access to. You know, if you can stop that from happening, then that app becomes quiet. It's gonna sleep. It's gonna be there until you need it, and then it's gonna get active. But because it's also not being exposed to the internet, it will also not be busy with, you know, because these rights you will be able to tweak in there. So this is in fact very good, because ROMs don't come this way. You know, most ROMs that you get, or I mean most official firmware that will come with a phone, in fact will not let you do all these things. You are not allowed to do so. So yeah, that's in fact a little bit a pity, right? So that's why we have Linux OS and Resurrection. So I'm gonna bring you a little bit closer here, and then we're gonna install it, and then I'm gonna show you the complete thing. Also gonna show you, of course, again the BlackBerry mod that I'm gonna flash straight on top of this clean install of Resurrection Oreo. So yeah, you won't see the Resurrection remix boot animation. You will see, of course, the boot animation that I used for this project, and this is in fact the BlackBerry Prive mod. You know, it will give these look and feels to the phone to make it kind of look like a BlackBerry Prive. Same thing that we do with iOS and with all these crazy modeled mods and ROMs that come from Channel 48 and from Pukrom. So okay, let's get started. Let me put you on the tripod. By the way, this is my latest invention. It's a coffee bottle, and you can fill it with rice, and then you have a very nice stand, because the stand that you see, this tripod, it was on something that you could put on the table, but it broke within 2 days. And I found it kind of a waste to throw it away. By the way, from Maxer, I even painted the bottle to kind of let it look nice in the studio. So that's that. Let's get started. Okay, there we are. So the phone is still charging. It's 1800. Not really. It's 8 o'clock. But this thing is not really on time. So what we're gonna do, we're just gonna reboot, restart. Oh, I forgot. We had to restart in recovery. I'm just gonna do it like this. Come on. Yes. There we go. You see, it's 9505. So all you guys with 9500, this is not for you, okay? We're gonna do a wipe, advanced wipe, Dalvik system data and catch. Gonna wipe the whole thing. Ta-dum. And the system was wiped. We go one back. And it's busy on my channel. Yes, yes, I will answer you soon. And we go back home and then install. And we go down. So, the ROM. Here it is. Oreo Official GFL Text. That's, I renamed the file. And here you can see it. And the maintainer is Buff 99, so Buffalo Buff 99 builder, big up to you. And of course, big up to the complete resurrection team out there. Thank you for your time and effort that you take to, you know, update these old devices. You guys are really blessed. Of course, and the ladies as well. The coffee girls that are serving the coffee. Not to forget all of you out there working on this, making this possible. Resurrection version 6.2 is amazing to see that this is happening on such an old phone. Because this is still a very great phone, guys. Make no mistake. Even though, it's not the newest phone anymore. It's still a great phone. Okay? Make no mistakes. I just flashed my mod on top of it. And I'm also gonna install... Well, I don't have my keys here. I'm not even sure. Let's see if the ROM is rooted already. Because it could be that my keys is already installed. And then it would be 17. And then I don't want to install 16 onto it. Okay. So we're just going to reboot. Reboot into the system. And... meanwhile, maybe we can take a look at the boot time. Stopwatch, I think, was here. And you can see that the BlackBerry boot animation fits really nice in the S4. So yeah, this phone will have great look and feels with this BlackBerry mod. Official BlackBerry tools were used. BlackBerry is also having many applications online that you can test out. You can also download the launcher and install it yourself. You know, but this will be different. This is like permanently flashed to the phone. if I'm going to do a wipe data factory reset, you know, if I'm going to go into settings of Android and say reinstall, wipe everything and, you know, do the complete thing, then it's going to come back just like this. That's the difference. That's the difference when flashing a mod. It becomes like one with the phone. And these mods are great for people that don't always have access to the internet, because they can immediately get started. Because you don't need the internet immediately to start downloading something, because it's already on the phone. You can listen to music, you can watch video, make videos and do some other offline stuff. And when you get on the, when you find the internet connection, just grab the APK Pure Store that's in the mod, built in, and get any app you need. If you want to watch YouTube, go to XDA and download the YouTube mod. It will run without Google services. I might flash that into my mods, so it kind of becomes permanently spread. Because this guy did a great job creating that application. And then you have a YouTube app that will just run without Google services. So you don't need to install GAPS. It's not mandatory. None of my phones have GAPS because they become kind of slow. These are not the latest phones anymore. You know, before we had Market. Market was a small little application of some megabytes, you know, and that we used to in fact download our applications. But the thing only grew. And then we got all these extra applications that came, that innovation, you know, all these things. Yeah, I think the animation looks the best on the S4. And then, in fact, yeah, everything became a little bit different. Bigger files, more bandwidth needed, more this, more that. You know, before we could deal with 3 gigabytes of, 3G connection. Now we need 4G. Because in some way, our life became so important that we need to all sorts of Gs now to get by. And I don't agree with that. We don't need all these Gs. You know? It's nonsense. For what? For what do we need it? What are we doing with the phone? These phones, long time already, were fine devices. You know, when in 1995 a computer could play music and video, it became a great device. Way back in 1995, when we got Windows 95, you know, and Windows 3.1, it was not that easy. It was already possible, but it was not that easy. You could play VCDs in Windows 3.1, but in 95 the thing became a multimedia center. Since then, these devices could do fantastic things. If it comes up to music, watching a video, and then it only became better and better and better and better. But you can also ask yourself, how much better should it get? Because it's already great. Okay, let's get back to the ROM, guys, because I'm talking way too much about the past. If you long press, you can immediately change your wallpaper, and BlackBerry inserted some very nice, beautiful wallpapers in the launcher. So there it is, boom. You have the pixel icons, but that was thanks to Resurrection, of course. Resurrection pushed these icons immediately into the phone. But then again, this is not BlackBerry phone. So to get the real BlackBerry thing, we're gonna go to icon packs and we select the BlackBerry icon pack. This is crazy. And then we set it. And then we wait a second, we go one back, and boom, the BlackBerry icon pack was in a way implemented. I still see some other pixel icons there, but that particular phone there, you know, and maybe This one is also fun to use. This is the BlackBerry Messenger. It affects something like WhatsApp. I'm kind of thinking of using this in the future. This BBM app. Just because it's so secure and it's just fine. It's great. Okay, but this is not WhatsApp Race or whatsoever. You can see that the background is white. And if that is hurting your eyes, simply long press, go to settings, and go to the theme, and set it to dark. And then here in icon layout, you can also make the icons a little bit smaller or bigger, whatever your wishes. But for me, this is the coolest setting. I like this. And then up here, you will find all your icons. You can also make 3 rows or 4 rows. I think this is just fine, right? And you can go here. This is your settings part. This will automatically change by the wallpaper that you're using. But if you really want this black, just go to display, advanced, and then here, style. Okay, and then in the style, you can select dark black, so it always stays dark black. Use black theme, and then it's gonna apply the theme. You see that? Boom. And the accent colors, I like them kind of orange. Okay, I'm from Holland, so we love orange. Okay, orange is our national color, and I love it. It also looks great, as you can see. And that orange will come back in certain things that you do. Would you like to save a file? Will then be in orange. It will look just beautiful. But that's of course up to you, whatever you want on your phone. I also like my clock. Did you see the orange text there? But I love it in the middle. I can't stand the clock that does not stand in the middle. Drives me nuts. So I have to make it a little bit bigger, like that. Boom, there you go. Look at that. I don't want no icons on here. So this one, these are apps that you can download from BlackBerry, but you can take a look at that for yourself. And this is it. And about the phone system. i9505, and then you can see it, Android 8.10, and the security patches were from the 5th of September. That is very, very, very amazing. Fender security patch level was 9th November 2017. Oh, wait a minute. So Android security, what is Fender security patch level? I don't know about that. That looks kind of old to me, but these are the Fender. Probably the creators' security patches that these phones have, probably on the stockroom, are from 9th November 2017. So that is very outdated. So yeah, with this ROM, you're having a way better, protection, privacy, everything. I think, because this ROM is of course a very, very powerful ROM, and everything that you find in Lineage OS, you will also find in here. The privacy guard, you know, they did not rip it out because, you know, they don't want it to be in there. It's right here. You see, this is the most powerful tool that exists in Android ROM world. You know, the privacy guard, this thing here. You can here run in background, boot up, for instance, here. You can decide what you want to boot up. You see? Oh, wait a minute. I already pushed my YouTube mod into here. I never saw it. Here it is. This will work without Google services. It's amazing. So that's great, you know? And yeah. That's how we get by and live without, you know, being depending on only one source. My source for applications is APK Pure, really, these guys, I really love them. They're really great. And they take good care of the applications. I never found any bad application in here. But then again, I also have Bitdefender to protect me from that happening. And most of the times the apps, if they would do a bad thing, thanks to my strong firewall, they will not get to the internet to do whatever they wanted to do. So yeah, and then the story is over for them, right? That's just how it is. So now we're gonna restart and I will have to gain some root. In fact, I should get Magic 17 onto it. Yes. That is the two-finger recovery method. It's gonna bring us to twerp. There we go. And I'm just gonna let me see. Magisk 16.3. This is very old Magisk. Let me connect to this PC. And let me just get Magisk 17.1. I'm gonna copy that straight to the phone, to the belly of the phone, so we can flash it. Boom, paste. Okay, and it was pasted. And now we're not gonna see it yet. So what we're gonna do is we're just gonna go to a folder and we go there back and we say install again, upper level. And now it should be there. And we're flashing Magisk. So we're gonna have root access. As you could see, we had no root just now. So yeah, you can install this ROM without even rooting the phone. Only thing that you must do is put the phone in a download mode connected to Windows computer that has the Samsung phone USB drivers installed. Get a tool like Audin 3, any version will do, and simply flash the latest twerp that you can find at twerp.me to the phone, okay, version 3, and then you're good to go. Then you can flash this ROM. So in fact, yeah, every Samsung S4 out there, the 9505, you know, can run Oreo now officially. So this is really great. So yeah, I really love it, and I also love the mod. The mod looks great. Oh, look there, 1818. Ooh. So there we go. This looks amazing. All the great apps are included. Extuned, even Substranium is included. But why would you use Substranium? I see no reason. Maybe if you want the light theme with the colorful icon pack, you could use Substranium, but I think it's just fine. You know, Substranium makes your phone lag. And we're trying to avoid these kinds of things happening to the phone. So yeah, now it's just a matter of setting up your phone, guys. And yeah, you will have to do that yourself. And I think this will take up to 10 minutes, you know, going through all the applications and give them the rights that you want them to have, and nothing more, nothing less. Okay, I'm sure I did not say too much. It's fantastic to see our Samsung, beloved Samsung S4, now being updated officially to Oreo. So once again, all maintainers, developers, muchas gracias. See you in the next video, and that will be about some I don't even know.